Good evening. I'd like to call the Poquoson City School Board meeting of April 19, 2016 to order. Drew?
Good evening. Landon Hermansky will lead us in the pledge tonight. Landon is in Ms. Bowen's first grade class. Landon is the son of Mr. and Mrs. Matt Hermansky. He has an older brother, Braden, who is in third grade at PES. Landon loves to play outside with his friends on the trampoline. He also likes to play on his iPad when he is not at school. His favorite subjects are PE and music.
Join us in the saying of the Pledge of Allegiance to the flag.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, Landon. We love the enthusiasm out of the corner over there. Our inspirational reader tonight is Palin Moody. Palin is a student also in Ms. Bowen's class. Palin is the daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Allen Moody. She has an older brother, Jacob, who is in seventh grade at Poquoson Middle School. Palin loves to play Yarn Yoshi on her Wii when she is not at school. Her favorite subjects in school this year are PE. Palin will read a poem titled Americans in Strength by Roger Ribishu.
Americans in Strength by Roger Ribishu. Americans in strength unite this union born in freedom's light. United States, how sure we are, will pull together near and far. The world can see of what we're made. Each state is of the highest grade. Determination filled with pride, our people's will won't be denied. Our founding fathers set to stay the road we travel to this day. A quest for right cannot be wrong. With help from God, we will stay strong. Support our troops ranks number one, for the job they do is never done. When forced, they put it on the line. True patriots, when called, they shine. Let's raise our glory with a cheer and thank all soldiers past and here.
Great job, Landon and Palin. The name of the student presentation tonight is God Bless America, sung by Mrs. Bowen's first grade class from Poquoson Primary School. They are under the direction of Mrs. Poto. And students, right after your presentation, if you would stay with us a little while, we're going to have a couple of recognitions, then we're going to take a break. We'd love to come out and visit with you. And also, parents and friends, this is being televised, and there will be a link available that you can send to all of your relatives, grandparents, anybody who might be interested. Take it away.
Yeah.
Fantastic. Thank you. Dr. Parrish, do we have any additions or modifications to the agenda?
We do not this evening.
Okay, we'll move on to recognitions. And I would like to invite Brian Lockwood to come forward. Mr. Lockwood is here on behalf of the Poquoson Art League. The Art League continues to be very supportive of our art programs. And I'd also like to ask that our art teachers come forward. Helena Mulligan from the primary school, Marcel Fenter from the elementary school, Stephanie Thompson from the middle school, Paula Bennett and Marie Wilton from the high school.
I even have something for me to stand on.
Wow, I'm really tall.
Thank you very much. My name is Brian Lockwood. I'm with the Poquoson Art League here in Poquoson. I feel very happy to be able to present some checks to our four schools on behalf of the Poquoson Art League. They've been doing this for several years now, and we hope to continue to do it for several years more. It's not a great amount of money, but it will help. It's for the art teachers in the art school in the schools, and it's $750 for each of the schools. So it's $3,000 that we're giving to them. So I'm not sure who is who, but this is for the primary school.
Thank you.
The elementary school. Hopefully it will be.
Brian, we thank you and the Poquoson Art League, and you said you're very happy to give them. We're very happy to receive.
While Mr. Cass is moving over to our recognition area, I'd like to ask at this time for Chris Tyler to come forward. We're actually going to be recognizing Mrs. Tyler more than once this evening, but this recognition is because she was selected as the York Region Librarian of the Year. Mrs. Chris Tyler has been serving students and teachers in public education for the last 21 years. This is her 6th year as a library and media specialist at Poquoson Middle School. Over the past 6 years, there's been an evident, positive, and influential transformation of what the library means to the Poquoson Middle School students and staff. Mrs. Tyler is a faculty advisor for the Builders Club, a community service-based club, which is connected with the Kiwanis Club, who's also with us this evening, the Chess Club, the Library Helpers Club, and the Battle of the Books. Mrs. Tyler volunteers to chaperone at all of the middle school dances. She was the only staff member to be at all of the dances last year, and that certainly says something. In addition to chaperoning, Mrs. Tyler sponsors dances and uses the profits to enhance her resources in the library and media center. She works with a local PTO to help support and promote the discussion of books through her monthly lunch bunch sessions, where students can eat in the library in groups and discuss books, eat a cookie, and engage in dialogue through prompts and suggested discussion questions. Mrs. Tyler updates her bulletin boards on at least a monthly basis. If she's not promoting a specific reading theme with her bulletin boards, she's using them to promote her author visits. This year, she has already had 3 different authors present assemblies with opportunities to ask questions and work with in sessions with students. For the last 2 years, students in the English honors classes have read the novel of a particular author that later visited the middle school. Mrs. Tyler sets circulation goals based on school-wide goals. She meets with every English teacher and their classes once a week to plan, present lessons, and co-teach with them. Mrs. Tyler recently supported Poquoson Middle School's Writing Across Disciplines goal by providing students with the opportunity to write a persuasive essay on e-books versus paper books. She's worked through the English classes to promote this essay contest while at the same time promoting the resources available in her media center. Teachers know they can approach Mrs. Tyler with an upcoming unit or content theme for resources and supplementary materials. Mrs. Tyler is a true team player. She finds ways to include staff in her promotion of reading. She attends faculty functions, volunteers her time, promotes school spirit, and supports school and division initiatives through the library and its resources. It is no wonder that she was selected as the Virginia Association of School Librarians York Regional School Librarian of the Year. Please join me in congratulating her. like to recognize a couple of students. So if first Brian Chow would come forward. We're recognizing Brian and another student for their success with DECA, or the Distributed Education Clubs of America. They were both state winners. Brian Chow is a freshman at our high school. He won third place in finance at the DECA state competition, which qualifies him for the International Career Development Conference competition in Nashville, which will be held this month. He participates in DECA Club and Poquoson High School JV soccer. He is a first-class scout in Boy Scout Group 94. In addition, he plays soccer with the Virginia Legacy Soccer Club. Please join me in congratulating Brian Chow for placing third in the state. Next, if Rachel Morrison would come forward, please. Rachel is a senior at Poquoson High School. She placed in the top three in two of her events at the DECA State competition and placed in the top nine in Food Market Series, which qualifies her for the International Career Development Conference competition. She has been in DECA for 2 years, president of Teens for Troops, treasurer of Model United Nations, and SCA historian. Rachel is a member of the Key Club, Student to Student, and French and National Honor Societies. She's a student ambassador to the American Heart Association. Rachel will attend Christopher Newport University this fall and major in history. Please join me in congratulating Rachel on her success with DECA. And I know we all wish you both the best of luck in the next competition. Hopefully we'll see you back. Next, if McAllen Cruff would come forward, please. No stranger to our meetings. Callie was awarded the National Center for Women in Information Technology Award for Aspirations in Computing. She was the winner for Virginia and the Washington, D.C. region for computing-related achievements and interests. Awardees are selected for their computing and IT aptitude, leadership ability, academic history, and plans for post-secondary education. They also receive opportunities for scholarships, internships, research experiences, and other educational and employment opportunities provided by NCWIT member organizations. Callie is a student at the Governor's School for Science and Technology. She did an internship at Christopher Newport University, and as part of that worked on programming. She focused on humanitarian, free, and open source software. Callie plans on attending Carnegie Mellon University in the fall. Please join me in congratulating her for being recognized by the National Center for Women in Information Technology. Congratulations. Now I'd like to take a few minutes to recognize another group of people who are obviously very important to us, and that would be our Teachers of the Year. First, I'd like to invite our Poquoson Primary School 2016 Teacher of the Year, Mrs. Nina Richardson, to come forward. Nina is completing her 13th year as a teacher with Poquoson Schools. She believes her students need to have a structured and caring learning environment in which they do their best. Nina received her undergraduate degree from Christopher Newport University and her master's from Virginia Commonwealth University. When she's not busy engaging her kindergarten students in learning, you can often find Mrs. Richardson at the high school on a volleyball court where she is an assistant coach. Please join me in congratulating Mrs. Nina Richardson on being named the Poquoson Primary School Teacher of the Year. We are going to ask that our Teachers of the Year all stay up front while we do the next recognition as well. This year's Teacher of the Year for the Poquoson Elementary School is Mrs. Sarah Brichetti. If she would come forward, please. She believes that every morning is a fresh opportunity to welcome her students with a smile and to help them have the best day yet. Sarah completed her undergraduate work at Longwood University and received a Master's of Education from Old Dominion University. She has taught both fifth and third grade at our elementary school and feels that teaching is the best part of her day. She loves creating and implementing hands-on lessons with her students, building real-world connections, and showing students just how fun learning can be. Please join me in congratulating Mrs. Brichetti on being named Poquoson Elementary School Teacher. I mentioned earlier, we are going to see Mrs. Chris Tyler. She would come forward because she was selected as the Poquoson Middle School Teacher of the Year this year. As I mentioned earlier, she has 21 years of teaching experience, with the last six being with us in Poquoson. She completed her undergraduate work at Meredith College and holds master's degrees from the University of Alabama and the University of Florida. Chris Tyler believes in respecting the individuality of all students, noting that there are so many different individuals that attend our school, and each one is striving to find authenticity for his or her life. Please join me in congratulating Mrs. Chris Tyler for being named Poquoson Middle School's Teacher of the Year. And if Poquoson's High School Teacher of the Year, Mrs. Paula Bennett, would come forward, please. Paula has spent her 25 years of teaching at Poquoson schools. As an art teacher, she believes that art can spark a student's imagination, promote skill development, and encourage them to take risks as they engage in the creative process. Paula completed undergraduate and graduate coursework at Virginia Commonwealth University and has taught every art course the high school has to offer over the course of her career. Please join me in congratulating Mrs. Paula Bennett on being named Poquoson High School's Teacher of the Year. I have to say that I have had the absolute pleasure of being in every one of their classrooms and have seen the wonderful things that they do for our students every day. So congratulations to all four of you. I really do appreciate the work that you do for our students every day. At this point, I'd like to ask Mr. Rick Neff, the president of Kiwanis, to come forward so that he can recognize our Teachers of the Year as well.
Well, thank you. Again, my name is Rick Neff. I'm the president of the Kiwanis Club of Poquoson. And for those of you that might not know, our motto is changing the world one child and one community at a time. And what better way to do that than investing in our schools, our teachers, and our students? And that's what we do. I mean, we're an international group, but we make sure that a lot that we do goes directly back into our community. You might see some of the things we do around here, and a big one's coming up on the 14th of May, our Kiwanis barbecue sale here in town. And all of that money that we raise in those events are coming right back to our community, at least a major portion of that. So what I have here in my hand are four letters for each one of our teachers and four checks for $250. And we want those checks to be a personal gift to each teacher to spend on themselves. Because we give a lot to the schools and scholarships and partnership with the Poquoson Education Foundation. So we really thought about it, and we want this to be a personal gift to you guys. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to read one of the letters, and then I'm going to hand you the checks. So congratulations on your selection as your school's Teacher of the Year. Poquoson is blessed to have one of the highest quality school programs in Virginia due to the dedicated efforts of all of our teachers being recognized as a top teacher in such elite company is truly a testament to your commitment and proficiency in educating our youth. The Kiwanis Club of Poquoson strives to embody the goals of Kiwanis International and positively change the world one child and one community at a time through our charitable work with Poquoson school system. Your exemplary efforts for the 2015-2016 school year mirror our own to be a positive influence on our youth and our community. We therefore are pleased and honored to present you with this $250 check in recognition of your outstanding work. So with that, I'm going to hand these over to each one of you. And the first one I have is for Sarah. I'm sorry, that's a little bit out of order. And here's one for Nina, Miss Volleyball. And for Chris, who is also our faculty advisor for our Builders Club. In fact, she presented an awesome presentation this morning at our morning meeting, which was just amazing. She had 10 kids came and talked to the group this morning, and it was awesome. So with that, thank you. Okay.
bear with us for a moment. We have our paparazzi.
That's a good thing.
Well, clearly we couldn't do what we do for our children without the incredible work that our teachers throughout the division do, but we also couldn't do what we do for children without the incredible volunteers that are in our schools every day. And so today I have the pleasure of recognizing on behalf of the school board the primary school volunteer of the month. So I'd ask at this time for Jillian Kennedy to come forward, please. And do know in the audience with her is her husband, David Kennedy, and her son, Maxwell, who's a second grader, and another son, Derek, who's in kindergarten. Jillian Kennedy is the Poquoson Primary School PTO Secretary. Along with keeping everyone informed on PTO matters, Mrs. Kennedy organizes parent volunteers to support the primary students and staff, photographs PTO events, and reads with students on a regular basis. Mrs. Kennedy regularly assists teachers with cutting, laminating, and other tasks in our PTO Helping Hands room. Mrs. Kennedy is always willing to help out the PPS school community, continuously asking what more she can do to support the school. Her bright smile is always a welcome sight during school events. Please join me in congratulating Jillian Kennedy for being the Primary School Volunteer of the Month. And again, I just want to thank Jillian, but also all of our volunteers, including Kiwanis folks who are here today who do so much for our schools, because we really wouldn't be what we are without all of you. So thank you. And now for our last recognition of the evening, and this is something that very few people know who's winning this award. So I'm going to now announce who the Division Teacher of the Year is. But first, a little bit about this award. The school-based awards are part of the State Teacher of the Year selection process. Each division selects a Teacher of the Year to move on to the Region 2 competition for State Teacher of the Year. Please know that this year, the Region 2 Teacher of the Year is Lauren Osborne, who is actually a Poquoson High School teacher. So we actually did move on last year and end up being one of 8 teachers selected across the state. Numerous criteria are used in evaluating the nominees, including the abilities of the teacher in the classroom and in communicating their message to a broad audience. Candidates are considered on the basis of the following criteria: inspire students of all backgrounds and abilities to learn, has the respect and admiration of students, parents, and colleagues, plays an active and useful role in the community as well as in the school, is poised and articulate, and possesses the energy to withstand a taxing schedule. It is my pleasure to announce this evening, and this person will need to come forward, that this year's Poquoson Teacher of the Year is Mrs. Chris Tyler, our media specialist at Poquoson Middle School.
We're going to take a short break so we can visit with you guys. Thank you. We'll come back to order. And could I call Mr. Bowen, please, for the financial update?
Good evening, Chairman Cass, members of the board, Dr. Parrish. Just a brief update for the financial report this evening. I'll begin with budget. The school board budget has been presented to the city, and the city has incorporated our proposed budget in their proposed financial plan. You have a copy of this document. It's been provided to you tonight. Just a note to the community, the proposed budgets for the school system and the city can be viewed at the public library. They can also be viewed online at our respective websites. Also, a reminder to the community, City Council and the School Board have a joint work session on Monday, April 25th at 6 p.m., and that will be here at City Hall. A couple of events that we have on the horizon. Open enrollment for employee benefits. That will begin on May 16th and run through June 17th. PCPS has a third-party administrator that assists us with this process. Staff is currently working with the third-party administrator to update the employee database. And we'll have additional information and a more formal communication for our employees by the end of the month. And lastly, while it seems we just completed our financial audit for 2015, the time has come to begin this work again. We have a planning meeting with our auditors the first week of May, and we anticipate that preliminary test work will begin on our FY16 audit by the end of May. And this concludes my report this evening.
Thank you very much. Any questions for Mr. Bowen? His audits just keep coming, don't they?
They do.
Mr. Pappas, could you come forward and give us the operations update, please?
Good evening, Chairman Cass, School Board, Dr. Parrish. Well, over the break, maintenance had a great opportunity to get into the schools and perform a myriad of preventive maintenance items. Among them were some remediation tasks that included sidewalk repair at both the high school and the primary school. Our security system enhancements have continued through the grant funding that we received, and that also moved into its final phase over the spring break. This last phase of implementation for the 2015-2016 grant was conducted, and that brought teachers online and some other finalization aspects of that. In food service, PCPS food service operations is out to bid. We are out for a one-year contract with up to 4 1-year renewals. It's called a RFP, request for proposal. As part of the request for proposal, PCPS held a mandatory pre-bid meeting for interested vendors. We had 4 companies show up for that meeting, and I expect that each one of them will present a response to the RFP. Those responses are due April 26th, and the committee will begin its selection process immediately thereafter. Transportation. Annually, PCPS participates in an all-day driver skills training program called the Rodeo, emphasis on the word R-O-A-D. And this is a full-day event. It starts with drivers taking a written exam first thing in the morning, and then they move into a driving skills portion of the training for the remainder of the afternoon. This is done by driving through a standardized nationwide, it's a standardized obstacle course. Each facet of the course is designed to test and challenge a driver's skills. Earlier this month, 5 of our PCPS drivers voluntarily went to Newport News to work with their people in their permanent training facility to sharpen their skills for our upcoming participation in our rodeo. Later, actually next month, the beginning of next month, the actual competition for PCPS will take place in conjunction with York County Transportation Department. And this year, 15 PCPS drivers will be participating. And that concludes the operations report.
Thank you, Mr. Pappas. Any questions or comments? Okay. Thank you very much. Dr. Colley, could you come forward and give the instructional update, please?
Yes. Good evening, Chairman Cass, members of the board, Dr. Parrish. April is month of the military child, and my update this evening focuses on this important connection we share with the military community right here in Hampton Roads. 30% of our students are military connected, and we serve students connected to the U.S. Coast Guard, Navy, Air Force, and Army. We work closely with our military liaisons to ensure smooth transitions for our students, as well as to enhance their educational opportunities. From deployments to new schools, military children are faced with unique challenges that ordinary youth their age never experience. Their ability to adapt to present and future changes deserves our respect and admiration. In an effort to recognize the hard work and applaud the courage of military children, the Department of Defense has deemed April as the month of the military child. Our schools have honored and recognized the military child throughout the month. We provided links and activities for teachers to use in the classroom, and all of our schools participated in Purple Up for the Military Child last Friday. If you get by the elementary school, you might want to look at the first floor bulletin board between the third and fourth grade pods. It showcases all the elementary school military-connected students and is entitled, Not Every Hero Wears a Uniform. At the high school, the student-to-student club provided cupcakes for the military-connected high school students last week. And this Friday, the middle school is hosting a luncheon recognition for its military-connected students, and all of them will be offered the special opportunity to lead the Pledge of Allegiance during the morning announcements in the coming weeks. PCPS benefits greatly from the presence of these resilient, determined students and families who persevere, oftentimes in the face of great stress. Our military-connected status has also led to our eligibility for competitive grants with the Department of Defense Education Activity. During 2011 through 2015, we received $350,000 to improve K-5 literacy instruction through our Reading for All grant. And last fall, we were awarded a five-year grant for $750,000 for our STEM Success for All project that focuses on college and career readiness in a changing world in the fields of math, engineering, technology, and science. These awards afford us a tremendous opportunity to focus on ensuring that our military-connected students and all of our students meet with continued success. And that concludes my update for this evening.
Thank you very much. Any questions, comments? Thank you.
Chairman Cass, I would like to make a motion that we move item E under the consent agenda to other matters for consideration.
Thank you very much. Do we have a second to move item E from the consent agenda?
Second.
Ms. Reimers?
Mr. Hawks?
Aye.
Ms. Rollins?
Aye.
Dr. Carter?
Aye.
Ms. Whitaker?
Aye.
Mr. Hokum?
Aye.
Mr. Melton?
Aye.
Chairman Cast?
Aye.
Motion passes 7-0.
Mr. Melton, can you now present the consent agenda?
It's been shortened a little bit. Okay. We have the approval of financial reports enclosed. B, approval of personnel action also enclosed. C, authorization to change appropriation in accordance with attached request enclosed. And finally, D, approval of minutes of the March regular meeting and work session enclosed.
Thank you. Do we have a motion to approve the consent agenda as presented?
So moved.
Thank you. Do we have a second?
Second.
Are there any comments or questions? Ms. Reimers?
Mr. Hucks?
Aye.
Ms. Rollins?
Aye.
Dr. Carter?
Aye.
Ms. Whitaker?
Aye.
Mr. Hokum?
Aye.
Mr. Melton?
Aye.
Chairman Cass?
Aye.
Motion passes 7-0.
Now we'll move do we have a motion to approve the minutes of the budget public hearing and special meeting on March 22nd?
So moved.
Do we have a second?
Second.
Thank you very much. Will you call the roll, please?
Mr. Hucks?
Aye.
Ms. Rock?
1 second. Do we have a question?
I do have a question.
Okay.
These two items are bundled together. However, I, for one, was only here for one item.
Okay.
And not the other one. Do we need to split this up then?
I think you could just, I mean, I think you could probably just abstain,
abstain.
On it, because we've got a majority that are
okay.
here.
Yes.
All right.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Is that why we moved this?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Thank you. I knew it, no, it was confusing, and I added to the confusion, but there are people here that know what they're doing.
Maybe in the audience, actually.
Now, we do have a motion and a second. Ms. Reimers, could
right.
you call for roll, please?
Mr. Hucks.
Aye.
Ms. Rollins.
Aye.
Dr. Carter.
Abstain.
All right. Ms. Whitaker.
Abstain.
All right. Mr. Hokum.
Aye.
Mr. Melton.
Aye.
Chairman Cass.
Aye.
Motion passes 5-2 abstentions.
Sorry, that was painful, but we will move on. Item A, consideration of approval of certification of closed meeting, and that is enclosed. Do we have a motion to approve?
So moved.
We have a second.
Second.
Any questions or comments? Ms. Reimers.
Mr. Hucks.
Aye.
Ms. Rollins.
Aye.
Dr. Carter.
Abstain.
Ms. Whitaker.
Abstain.
Mr. Hokum.
Aye.
Mr. Melton.
Abstain.
Chairman Cass.
Aye.
Motion passes 4-3 abstention.
Okay, consideration of approval of minutes of public hearing and special meeting on March 30th. Do we have a motion to approve?
So moved.
Do we have a second?
Second.
Do we have any questions or comments? Ms. Reimers?
Mr. Hucks?
Aye.
Ms. Rollins?
Aye.
Dr. Carter?
Abstain.
Ms. Whitaker?
Aye.
Mr. Hokum?
Aye.
Mr. Melton?
Aye.
Chairman Cass?
Aye.
Motion passes 6-1 abstention.
Okay, item C, consideration of approval to adjust the 2015-16 calendar. Dr. Parrish.
Yes, as you know, we build in every year, and in this year we did 2 inclement weather days. And we used both of those days in October because of some flooding that we had. And then what we did on January 18th is because on the calendar, we had already indicated that could become a makeup day. We made January 18th a makeup day, anticipating that we'd probably get additional winter weather as we move through the weather so that we'd still have another inclement weather day in play. We were fortunate this winter that we did not have to use an additional full inclement weather day. So we now have an additional day in our calendar. So if we take that day out of our calendar, we'll still meet the 180-day requirement by the state for 180 days. So what I'm proposing for you tonight is that we actually take 2 actions as part of the proposal. The first one is to make Friday, May 27th, which is the Friday before Memorial, an early release day. And some past years, we've actually made that the day that we sort of give everybody off as a replacement for it. But in talking with teachers quite a bit about this, what they talked about was the fact that we're in the middle of SOL testing at that point, so we're pulling a day out of the testing calendar and may lose a little momentum. So by making that an early release day, our families will still get an earlier start on the 3-day weekend, but it'll enable us to continue to do some SOL testing in the morning. And for the high school, it actually allows us that day, we're going to do social studies testing, which takes up 2/3 of our students actually take a social studies test. And so that we can have all students taking social studies tests that morning. And if they're not testing, the other students will actually stay home that day, which will make that testing that day much easier for our high school and for our high school students. Then the other action I'm proposing is that we make June 15th the last student day of the year. So that means that the 16th would become a work day for teachers, but graduation would still stay on Saturday, June 18th, because everybody's made plans for June 18th to be our graduation day. So we are putting sort of giving everybody back a day, but doing it by doing an early release one day and then shifting one of our half days back so we will get out of school a day earlier. So that's the proposal that I'm bringing for you tonight and asking approval of the calendar adjustment by making those 2 changes to it.
Thank you very much. Do we have a motion to approve these adjustments to the calendar?
So moved.
Do we have a second?
Second.
Any questions, comments? Do you think the students will be okay with being out of school a day earlier?
I think so. And I think the teachers will be too.
They'll be dancing in the street.
Ms. Reimers?
Mr. Hucks?
Aye.
Ms. Rollins?
Aye.
Dr. Carter?
Aye.
Ms. Whitaker?
Aye.
Mr. Hokum?
Aye.
Mr. Melton?
Aye.
Chairman Cass?
Aye.
Motion passes 7-0.
Item D, consideration of approval of special education plan for school year 2016-17. Dr. Parrish.
Yes, each year we bring this to you, and this is our formal agreement between us and the Virginia Department of Education in terms of us guaranteeing that we're implementing the IDEA Act appropriately. So we bring this to you every year at this time, and it does allow them to disperse federal funds to us to support our students with disabilities that are connected to this plan. You do have a reading file on this which outlines some more specifics about where that funding goes to, but it does help us to meet instructional needs and provides related services. Also helps us purchase services that include physical therapy, speech and language therapy, assistive technology, as well as acquiring software and curriculum material. So it does a number of other things as well, but we do need you to approve this plan as we do each year so that we can then get that to the Virginia Department of Education and continue to get the funding associated with that act.
Thank you. Do we have a motion for approval of this special education plan?
So moved.
Thank you. A second?
Second.
Thank you very much. Do we have any questions or comments? Ms. Reimers.
Mr. Hux?
Aye.
Ms. Rollins?
Aye.
Dr. Carter?
Aye.
Ms. Whitaker?
Aye.
Mr. Holcomb?
Aye.
Mr. Melton?
Aye.
Chairman Cass?
Aye.
Motion passes 7-0.
Item E, consideration of approval of the Perkins Grant, school year 2016-17. Dr. Parrish.
Yes, each year we also bring this to you, and the Perkins Act is what supports our career and technical education program throughout our school division. And so we are bringing forward to you our plan for that. Do you know this application is for just over $16,000, just so that our community knows we're not getting a whole lot of money from the Perkins Act. And what you had attached to your reading file, again, was a more detailed outline of where that funding would go. So I'm asking this evening that you approve the Perkins grant application.
Thank you very much. Do we have a motion for approval?
So moved.
Thank you. A second?
Second.
Thank you all very much. Any questions or comments? It was a tie.
I think
Ms. Reimers.
Mr. Hux?
Aye.
Ms. Rollins?
Aye.
Dr. Carter?
Aye.
Ms. Whitaker?
Aye.
Mr. Holcomb?
Aye.
Mr. Melton?
Aye.
Chairman Cass?
Aye.
Motion passes 7-0.
Okay. Item F, we have four proclamations tonight, and four very important proclamations. The first is Military Child Month, the month of April. Whereas thousands of brave Americans have demonstrated their courage and commitment to freedom by serving the armed forces of the United States, both on active duty in the National Guard and Reserves. Whereas the children of our service members continue to make significant contributions to Poquoson City Schools, the nation, and our Commonwealth, despite prolonged and repeated absences of one or both parents. Whereas April is month of the military child, a special month to recognize and pay tribute to military families and their children for their daily sacrifices made and for their commitment, courage, and unconditional support of our armed forces. And I'm gonna skip the language, but it is proclaimed Military Child Month. We will have a motion for all four in a minute. The next proclamation is Teacher Appreciation Week, May 2nd through the 6th, 2016. Whereas teachers work to open students' minds to ideas, knowledge, and dreams, and teachers fill many roles as listeners, explorers, role models, motivators, and mentors, and whereas teachers continue to influence us long after our school days end, whereas we honor the dedicated men and women who lend their passion and skills to educating our children, because we believe teaching is one of the most valuable professions in this country. And we are also going to proclaim that on this 19th day of April, Teacher Appreciation Week. The next proclamation is School Nutrition Employee Appreciation Week. Same week, May 2nd through the 6th, 2016, whereas nutritious meals at school are an essential part of the school day, and whereas the staff of Poquoson City Public Schools Meals and Nutrition Department are committed to providing healthful, nutritious meals to the school division's children, and whereas the hardworking staff who prepare and serve school meals help nurture our children through their daily interaction and support, and whereas the week of May 2nd through the 6th is National Child Nutrition Employee Appreciation Week. The next proclamation is School Nurse Appreciation Day. Whereas children are the future, and by investing in them today, we are ensuring the world for tomorrow. And whereas all students should have their health needs safely met while in the school settings. Whereas school nurses understand the link between health and learning, are in a position to make a positive difference for children every day. and we will proclaim it School Nurse Appreciation Day. And I hope everyone understands that by moving through those quickly, it doesn't minimize the appreciation we have for Military Child Month, Teacher Appreciation Week, School Nutrition Employee Appreciation Week, and School Nurse Appreciation Day. And do we have a motion to for all four of these wonderful proclamations?
So moved.
Do we have a second?
Second.
Any questions or comments?
Good stuff.
Good stuff. Thank you. Ms. Reimers.
Mr. Hucks?
Aye.
Ms. Rollins?
Aye.
Dr. Carter?
Aye.
Ms. Whitaker?
Aye.
Mr. Holcomb?
Aye.
Mr. Melton?
Aye.
Chairman Cass?
Aye.
Motion passes 7-0.
Okay. Dr. Parrish, would you kick off communications for us?
Yes, as Mr. Bowen mentioned, that we are moving through the budget process, so our budget is now in the hands of City Council because the city manager presented his budget this month, and we're looking forward to the joint meeting next week. I also just want to once again thank all of our teachers because Teacher Appreciation Week is coming, and this is a very busy time of year as they're preparing our students for a plethora of tests, the SOL test, the advanced placement test, and industry certification testing. So it's a busy time, and any support we can get from our parents, keeping our kids coming to school and getting ready would be very much appreciated. Thank you.
Thank you. Drew.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. We have a plethora of stuff to report on tonight because our schools are wonderfully
active.
So starting as usual with the primary school, Poquoson Primary first graders have been busy this month. They've performed for their parents a musical salute to the USA, March 28th, and took a field trip to the Children's Museum in Portsmouth. The IPOP, or IPOP students enjoyed a field trip to the Living Museum as well. PHS, or PPS students, plans to host a family STEM night tomorrow evening, which I believe is the 20th, from 6 to 7:30. Students and families are invited to explore several interactive STEM workshops, including robotics, building things, architecture, music, math, astronomy, 3D printing, and wireless devices. So lots of stuff to learn about. Moving on to the elementary school, last Friday there was the fantastic field day, always great memories from that, and Dr. Wood would like to extend a thank you to all the PTO and teachers who helped out to make that such a fantastic day for all students. The fourth graders are making plans to go to Williamsburg this Friday. This is a field trip that all students and many parents look forward to each year. Please check the PES website for the third quarter awards ceremonies that are to occur this week. The assemblies are split between 2 days, fourth graders on Thursday and third and fifth graders on Friday. The elementary school is in the month countdown to SOL testing, which begins May 11th. Please make sure your child gets to school on time and does not miss any school for absolutely any reason unless necessary, because every minute of education counts and it is important to do well on your SOL tests. Moving on to the middle school, report cards were issued last Friday, and the Honor Roll Ice Cream Social will be hosted by the PTO this Friday. The band spring concert is May 12th at 7 p.m. and the choral spring concert is May 19th at 7 p.m. Two very good concerts if you've never been. SOL test dates are posted online and are approaching soon. After school SOL prep and review invitations have been mailed out. Moving on to the high school. Sophomores have just placed ring orders. Ring orders. Moving fast. I remember that day last year. I was like, wow, this is going by really fast. And seniors just picked up their cap and gowns, meaning senioritis is at its all-time high. AP testing begins May 2nd. After-school tutoring has started for the upcoming SOL tests. Students and teachers have just returned from a very successful check exchange trip. And I had a couple of friends who went on the check exchange trip, sent back some pictures. It's enough to make you real jealous. You've never been. Zach Clark and Brody McDevitt have been selected as finalists in the Society of Naval Architects and Marine Engineers Boat Design Competition. The competition requires students to design the fastest and most maneuverable boat that abides by the design guidelines. This year's challenge was to design a whale watching vessel. Their boat design was one of four selected to be built by the Newport News Apprentice School, On April 30th, they will compete against the other finalists at the Mariners Museum in Newport News on Lake Maury to determine the overall winner. This event is open to the public, so please come and show their support. I'm good friends with both Zach and Brody. They're very smart, and they had a very well-designed boat. As part of the Reach Higher initiative, the counseling department has planned a field trip for ninth grade students to tour CNU and attend a presentation on the campus. Students attend over a period of 2 days. One of the days was today, the next day is tomorrow. They leave around 10 a.m. and will return about 1:30, and what I've heard from some of the freshmen, there's a very good field trip. That concludes my report.
Thank you, Drew. That was a plethora of items. Mr. Hux.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. No comment tonight.
Thank you. Ms. Rollins?
No comment.
Wow. Dr. Carter?
Yes. I attended the Special Education Advisory Committee meeting this past week with Dr. Feltman and Ms. Furlman, and Mr. Blackstock gave a presentation and an update on what they call a job coach, and they had two students there, Tyler Bell and Jesse Epstein, who, working with Mr. Blackstock, have gotten the mail, basically, I guess, with all the cutbacks, the pony mail within the school system had been reduced from 5 days a week to 2 days a week. Well, these two young men, with the help of Mr. Blackstock, have now gotten the pony mail up and running to 5 days a week again. So there was a need within the system, and these individuals filled that need. But not only that, they also deliver school within the city pony mail to Public Works, the police department, and the fire department. And the strides that these two young men have made this year, according to Mr. Blackstock, are just phenomenal. The skills that they've acquired, interpersonal skills, and things that we take for granted, these two young men have just excelled at this year. With Dr. Feltman's brainchild, and Mr. Blackstock helped put it in place. And it was very impressive, and one of the neatest things that I've heard about within the school system. So it was just, it was really, really good to be there to hear that and to hear from these two young men, because they actually helped with the presentation and answered questions. And it was just really good. And also thank you, Ms. Bowen and Ms. Poto. I'm glad that we are teaching our young children patriotism.
Absolutely.
So that seems to be a dying thing these days, and I'm glad we're still doing that and instilling that in our kids. So.
Thank you, Dr. Carter. Ms. Whitaker?
No comments.
Mr. Holcomb?
No comments, sir.
Mr. Melton?
Oh my gosh. Okay, so I have my bucket list, and I've only got two more months up here, so you guys get to endure this. Tonight, I'm going to send a shout out to all the career and business teachers, or career tech ed teachers and business teachers, and as I do that, I'll put on my apprentice school hat. I'll also point out to you that on our little board up here is that David Hux is an apprentice school graduate, and Dr. Carter happens to teach for the apprentice school, so we take this stuff pretty seriously. And I'll say, not only is this for our career technical and business teachers, this is also in memory of Paige Mentor, who was a longtime York County School Board member. He was inducted into the Career and Tech Ed Hall of Fame for the state of Virginia last year, and he's been the chairman at New Horizons for many years on their board of directors. He passed away in the last couple weeks. So we've lost a really good soul when it comes to career and technical ed and apprenticeships. So when a successful businessman was asked, who are the four most important people besides members in your family? He answered, my minister, my doctor, my lawyer,
thank you,
and my car mechanic.
That's right,
my car mechanic. So I'm very happy that the Poquoson City Schools' mission is to educate and prepare all students for success in college and career for responsible citizenship. And I'm going to read a couple quotes from an interesting fella. He said, sometimes meet people who've been through the university, and then they're doing an apprenticeship, and they say, well, Had I rather wished I had known about the apprenticeship in the first place, because of course, I could have been learning and earning at the same time rather than the path I took. Interestingly enough, same fellow said, we've got to invest in the number one resource, which is our people. And that means making sure that there is great skills, training, and great apprenticeships, making the most of people's talents. And that is what apprenticeships are all about. Now, interestingly enough, this fellow is the Prime Minister of Great Britain. And he said this when the Mercedes factory was opening up an apprenticeship in Great Britain, and they are a German company. And we have to remember that Rolls-Royce and Mercedes, those type of folks, they do a lot in the defense industry as well. So interestingly enough, it is very important that we support our career and technical ed teachers. So that's my shout out to the career and tech ed folks tonight. Thank you.
Mr. Melton, well done. And I'd like to put in a special request for your last meeting that you give us some wisdom from Dr. Seuss.
Could happen.
Okay. Very good. And I have no comments besides that one. Do we have any material for board review tonight?
You do. In addition to the budget that Mr. Bowen mentioned, you do have the statement of economic interest that we've given to you. As you may remember, the General Assembly changed that to a once-a-year filing to a twice-a-year filing. So you have that there, and we just ask that we get those back before the next board meeting and to our clerk, Ms. Reimer. So that's all I have for you.
We happily thank our friends at the General Assembly for that. So we stand adjourned. Thank you guys very much.
John, my friend.
Oh, well, it came from others.